Hello there. Topic for today is active and passive voice. Active voice means that a sentence has a subject that acts upon its verb. Passive voice means that a subject is a recipient of a verb's action. You may have learned that the passive voice is weak and incorrect, but it isn't that simple. When used correctly and in moderation, the passive voice is fine. In English grammar, verbs have five properties: voice, mood, tense, person, and number. Here, we are concerned with voice. The two grammatical voices are active and passive. Would you rather watch LeBron play basketball or some random person sitting in the stands? Do you know this is which voice? Don't worry, you'll know soon. Verbs and voice. Voice is the form a verb takes to indicate whether the subject of the verb performs or receives the action. A verb is a word or a combination of words that indicates action or a state of being or condition. A verb is the part of a sentence that tells us what the subject performs. Verbs are the hearts of English sentences. Examples: Jacob walks in the morning. There are two types of voice: active voice and passive voice. Voice is the term used to describe whether a verb is active or passive. In other words, when the subject of the verb is doing the action of the verb, e.g., the dog bit the postman, the verb is said to be in the active voice. So, the voice of a verb tells us whether the subject is acting or being acted upon. Active voice is used to show that the subject of the sentence is performing or causing the action. Active voice means that a sentence has a subject that acts upon its verb. Passive voice means that a subject is a recipient of a verb's action. You may have learned that the passive voice is weak and incorrect, but it isn't that simple. When used correctly and in moderation, the passive voice is fine. In English grammar, verbs have five properties: voice, mood, tense, person, and number. Here, we are concerned with voice. The two grammatical voices are active and passive. When the subject of a sentence performs the verb's action, we say that the sentence is in the active voice. Sentences in the active voice have a strong, direct, and clear tone. Here are some short and straightforward examples of active voice. Example: LeBron threw the basketball before the buzzer. LeBron shot the basketball from the free throw line. LeBron scored 3 points. When the subject of a sentence performs the verb's action, we say that the sentence is in the active voice. Sentences in the active voice have a strong, direct, and clear tone. Here are some short and straightforward examples of active voice. Active voice examples: monkeys adore bananas. The cashier counted the money. The dog chased the squirrel. All three sentences have a basic active voice construction: subject, verb, and object. The subject monkey performs the action described by adore. The subject the cashier performs the action described by counted. The subject the dog performs the action described by chased. The subjects are doing, they take action in their sentences. The active voice reminds us of the popular Nike slogan, "Just do it." Passive voice is used when the subject is the recipient of the action. In general, the active voice makes your writing stronger, more direct, and, you guessed it, more active. The subject is something, or it does the action of the verb in the sentence. With the passive voice, the subject is acted upon by some other performer of the verb. In case you weren't paying attention, the previous two sentences use the type of voice they describe. But the passive voice is not incorrect. In fact, there are times when it can come in handy. Read on to learn how to form the active and passive voices, when using the passive voice is a good idea, and how to avoid confusing it with similar forms. Sometimes the use of passive voice can create awkward sentences, as in the last example above. Also, overuse of passive voice throughout an essay can cause your prose to seem flat and uninteresting. In scientific writing, however, passive voice is more readily accepted since using it allows one to write without using personal pronouns or the names of particular researchers as the subjects of sentences. See the third example above. This practice helps to create the appearance of an objective, fact-based discourse because writers can present research and conclusions without attributing them to particular agents. Instead, the writing appears to convey information that is not limited or biased by individual perspectives or personal interests. Recognizing passive voice, you can recognize passive voice expressions because the verb phrase will always include a form of be, such as am, is, was, were, are, or been. The presence of a be verb, however, does not necessarily mean that the sentence is in passive voice. Another way to recognize passive voice sentences is that they may include a by the phrase after the verb. The agent performing the action, if named, is the object of the preposition in this phrase. Helpful hint. You can recognize passive voice because the verb phrase will include a form of be, was, am, are, been, is. Don't assume that just because there is a form of be, that the sentence is passive, however. Sometimes a prepositional phrase like, by the, in the sentences above indicates that the action is performed on the subject, and that the sentence is passive. Example: the ball was thrown by LeBron. The basket was shot by LeBron. The score was made by LeBron. Passive voice: a sentence is in the passive voice, on the other hand, when the subject is acted on by the verb. The passive voice is always constructed with a conjugated form of to be plus the verb's past participle. Doing this usually generates a preposition as well. That sounds much more complicated than it is. Passive voice is actually quite easy to detect. For these examples of passive voice, we will transform the three active sentences above to illustrate the difference. Passive voice examples: bananas are adored by monkeys. The money was counted by the cashier. The squirrel was chased by the dog. Let's take a closer look at the first pair of sentences: monkeys adore bananas, and bananas are adored by monkeys. The active sentence consists of monkeys, subject, plus adore, verb, plus bananas, object. The passive sentence consists of bananas, object, plus are adored, a form of to be plus the past participle adored, plus by, preposition, plus monkeys, subject. Making the sentence passive flipped the structure and necessitated the preposition by. In fact, all three of the transformed sentences above required the addition of by.